Hi, everybody. Welcome back to Bold and our ongoing live coverage of the 2011 BMO Canadian Figure Skating Championships from Victoria, British Columbia. I'm PJ Kwong, and I'm delighted to be alongside three-time Canadian champion José Chouinard, who's going to be on hand for all of the live skating coverage. We're just a few minutes away from the start of the women's event. Now, you probably know a thing or two about ladies figure skating.
Just a little.
Just a teeth in. So let's start off by talking about the dominance of the Quebec Federation here in these Canadian championships. I'm looking at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 competitors out of 18. That's a pretty remarkable number. What do you attribute it to?
Well, I can say that, at the present time, like Manon Perron, who coached Joannie throughout her career, is working alongside with the Quebec Federation on the development of their talent there in Quebec. But it has come and started a long time, like much longer than that, much prior to that. I believe that they always did some sort of a training camp, a summer elite training camp. They've regrouped all their elite skaters in Quebec to train together. And you know that, I can tell you from my own experience, I moved to Toronto from Quebec to train with Louis Tong, and alongside with Karen Preston, who was probably my main rival for the national title. And when you have your rivals and training like in a site where all the competitors are there, you have no choice to give 100% every day. And that's what Quebec was doing for many, I would say, 5 summers that I actually participated myself as 12, 13, like growing up in the pre-novice, novice ranks. So these are the things that the Quebec are doing. They're actually really helpful financially and also helpful at regrouping their talent, pushing them, giving them opportunity, and training with coaches, guest coaches that they're bringing in.
So we're going to do our little thing that we talked about before, and that's PJ's podium picks. And I bring up the Quebec Federation because I predict a Quebec sweep. So let's take a look at PJ's podium picks. I think that Cynthia Phaneuf is going to take the gold for the first time since 2004. I think that Amélie Lacoste, based on her strength this season, is going to take silver. And Marianne Samson is going to take the bronze. Now, José, your picks. What do you think?
Well, I must agree with you. Cynthia Phaneuf is the favorite going into the field of the ladies for these nationals. It has been 7 years since the last title. She is ready. She is determined to go back home with the gold medal and nothing less. Amélie Lacoste, well, she's had a great season, very determined. She's probably the strongest and most anxious skater out there. She's had a great Grand Prix final presence this season. Also, Marianne Samson was the one that took the spot to get to Worlds in 2010, replacing Joannie Rochette. So great competition out there, and Marianne Samson is probably the most consistent of the 3 skaters.
Well, it's interesting to see, and we're going to get a chance to see all those skaters coming up in our next event, which is the Women's Short Program. So let's take a quick look at Cynthia Phaneuf, some of the things that I think set her apart and put her in position to be able to take the 5th highest spot at the World Championships last year. Lyrical, elegant, beautiful line, and tremendous strength. Can you comment on that, José?
Well, look at the height on her triple toe. These are the quality that Cynthia has. She's got presence, she's got a whole, like what we call in skating, a package. Because she's got the program components going for her, she's got the difficulty and the intricacy in the choreography. She's been working with David Wilson for many, many years, and her jumps. Yes, we did see a fall there, but the height and the quality when they're successfully landed is the top in the world.
I think so too. And then Amélie Lacoste has the highest total point score of the Canadian women coming into these national championships based on tenacity, on just sheer stubbornness to go out there and skate. She earned her first Grand Prix medal at Skate Canada, where she took the bronze. And I think that she's a definite podium threat here for sure. Amélie Lacoste.
She's powerful and very fast on the ice.
Now, do you like the way that she's able to connect to the music What do you see in terms of the development of her line?
I think she has grown a lot, definitely made a big step this year. I think she still has a place to growth, for growth, but definitely has the goodies for it. Triple loop, double loop.
Beautiful jumper. Now there's another skater we need to talk about. Last year at the challenge event, this next skater, Myriane Samson, took the challenge event, then came to Canadians and would not take no for an answer. So she went home as the national bronze medalist, qualified for a spot at the World Championships where she didn't qualify to skate the free. But tell me the qualities that you like about Myriane's skating.
Her line, she's a graceful skater, but then again, the top three skaters are very strong jumper. This is a mark that the Canadian skaters always has, whether it's the men's field or the ladies' field. We always marked ourselves as a strong jumpers. And technically, a lot of the skaters coming from other countries come and train in Canada because they want to know what makes us good skaters and good jumper.
And really, Canadian skating has the ability, certainly with Lori Nicol and David Wilson and so many of the other choreographers, Shailen Bourne, are really the choreographers that the world is coming to. So let's talk a little bit about Canadians. So the women are getting ready to take the ice for their warm-up. Tell me about the first time you won the Canadian title. Where were you? What year were you expected to win?
Well, my first title was in 1991. We go way back. and the first title was sweet, exciting. I think the pressure that came after, I must say the second title was a little bit harder for me to achieve because there was a 2 years gap in between. It's not 7 years like Cynthia Phaneuf, but there was a bit of an adjustment with the pressure of being the reigning Canadian champion. Everyone is looking up at you, and you can't start looking down. You still have to set the goals higher and higher. And that was a struggle for me. I must say, the third one, this is where I felt the most comfortable with. This is where I belong. This is going into the event, this is where I saw myself, even though, you know, as a competitor, you have to see yourself where you want the results to end. But there, all along, this is where I was supposed to be, like the Canadian champion. So it was maybe not as exciting, and maybe, but it was maybe even better.
Sweet. Victory is sweet.
Yes.
So when we're looking at the Canadians and the Canadian women who are going to take the ice shortly, the final group of competitors are probably 2.5 hours away or so. Once the event gets underway, as that top-ranked group, are they off the ice warming up? Where are they in terms of their routine?
Well, when they're setting up, like, they have a routine that starts the time that they get up in the morning to the time that they get off at night. And if it's the short program, then they know what time they're going to bed and what time they're getting up the next day. It's planned to the second. What time you're putting on makeup. And most of them, like we were talking about superstition, like you do have your order on and off the ice.
Well, it's going to be a very exciting evening of competition, I have no doubt. I mean, how exciting for me and for all of the fans watching to have a Canadian champion in the house. So the judges are ready. We are too. It's going to be not very long before we get underway with our first group of competitors. We hope you'll stay tuned to Bold for all of the live coverage from Victoria. And we'll be back after this short break. Here is the start list. So a couple of names that you will or will not know, perhaps to start with Daniela Bella-Favot from Western Ontario, Sarah Jourdain, one of the Quebec skaters we were talking about, Karine Chevrier, same thing. When we get into the second group of competitors, there are some names that are perhaps a little bit more familiar. Kate Charbonneau, former junior national champion, Riley McCullough-Casarsa from Western Ontario, and of course, Jessica Dubé, skating ninth. She is partner to Bryce Davison and is competing in singles without very much training time. And then our final group of competitors, we're going to be looking at Adriana De Sanctis, Alexandra Najaro, Vanessa Grenier, who won the challenge event coming to these championships, Amélie Lacoste, Myriane Samson, and Cynthia Phaneuf. So,
José Chouinard, what is everybody doing as they're getting ready to hit the ice? So there are women in the change room. Has everybody arrived on site for the competition?
Some of them, no. The last group of skaters, you usually know how much time you need when you get to the rink. As we talked about routine, there's a certain amount of time that you're comfortable. I remember like planning even my social when I get to the rink. I knew I was going to meet some people, so I even planned that out.
So you left enough time?
Left enough time for this. So usually skaters arrive between an hour and a half.
So in our first group, here's the skating order. Daniela Bellafavo, Karine Chevrier, Jessica Amy Sargent, Kelsey McNeil, Sarah Jourdain, and Jacqueline Lenwick.
So when you arrive at the rink, you set yourself into the dressing room. You carry your skates at all times. It's very, very important. You don't leave your skate out of sight. Either you or your coach carry your skate. And you, this is Daniela Bellafavo.
So how long would Daniela, how long ago would she have arrived?
Probably an hour to an hour and a half prior to stepping on the ice for her warm-up.
She was 11th at Nationals last year, and she's coached by Galina Zmijevskaya and Viktor Petrenko. Now, Karine Chevrier. Karine was 14th at the challenge event. Now, Jeffrey Battle and Sebastian Bertin are responsible for her choreography. Natalie Martin is her coach. This is Jessica Amy Sargent. She was 13th at the challenge event, first time at Senior Nationals, coached by Jan Olmark and Deborah Allen.
Kelsey McNeil.
She represents New Brunswick with Kathy Grenier and Robert Leger as her coaches. She was 12th at the challenge, and this is her first time qualifying for Nationals in senior. Sarah Jourdain, Annie Barabé, Sophie Richard are the coaches, along with Sebastian Britton. 11th at the challenge event. And our final competitor in this group, Jacqueline Lenwick, coached by Jill Marie Harvey. She was 10th at the challenge event, first time qualifying for senior nationals. So it's kind of exciting to see all of these brand new skaters. So let's run through. We're going to run through the elements when we come back, but first it's going to be time for a short break before we come back to this first group of women's short program competitors. Stay tuned. So we're partway through the warm-up of this first group of women's short program competitors at the 2011 BMO Canadian Figure Skating Championships. I'm PJ Kwong. I'm here with José Chouinard. So José, tell me what the ladies are going to be doing for their short program.
Well, there's three jumps that they have to execute in this short program, double or a triple axel. Any triple jump, as long as it's immediately preceded by connecting steps or other free skating movements, a jump combination, you have a choice of double, triple, or triple, triple. A flying spin, a minimum of eight revolutions, layback or a sideways leaning spin, a spin combination, and a step sequence.
So there's lots going on, and that's 2 minutes and 50 seconds maximum. Now, for those of you that want to be in touch, there's @skatingPJ, which is Twitter, PJKwong at PJKwong.com. And I just received a text message. My grandpa and I are watching Bold here in Ilderton, and he really wanted me to text and say hi. Missing you all in Victoria. Congratulations to all the skaters. See you in a month. Guess who that's from? Scott Moyer.
Scott Moyer, nice.
Nice to know that even if you're not at Canadians, you're watching Canadians.
That's right. Well, it's like you were saying, it's a family. So he's got a lot of people that he's probably cheering from home, wish that he would be there to just encourage them.
So speaking of encouraging, let's watch Daniela Bellafavo skating to Jalousie. She's 19 years old. trains at the Ice House. Her coaches are Galina Zmiyevskaya and Viktor Petrenko. Choreographers Nikolai Morozov, Galina Zmiyevskaya, and Nina Petrenko. Placed 15th at the Challenge this year, 11th at last year's Canadian Championships.
Triple loop double toe is her first combination jump. Double axel.
They can change the order of the jumps as they're performed, but they do submit their program elements in order for the judges to be able to input them in the computer for evaluation.
Here's triple sow. There's a bit of a lack of connecting steps prior to it.
Now, how many revolutions are they looking for in each of the positions?
If you want to get an increase the level of difficulty, they're looking at 8 revolution in the same position, and you're looking at this level to reach. You're aiming for the level 4 in each spin. Her combination: double flip, double toe. That is not what she had planned as far as content of the program.
Nice extension on that Bielman position.
One foot. Half of the sequence has to be executed on one foot to get a difficult variation. Seems like she has reached it by now.
I like the use of the knees in order to sort of propel her across the ice.
An outside edge. She's got her 2 rotations. Broken leg into the grab.
What is the more difficult part, the flexibility or maintaining the momentum of the spin?
Both, because it requires a lot more strength. One is the flexibility, but to hold it for 8 rotation takes a lot more strength.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the South Windsor Figure Skating Club in Western Ontario, Daniela Bella-Favot.
We'll be right back with marks for Daniela Bella-Favot right after the short break. Please stay tuned. Daniela Bella-Favot just competed in her first time at the Senior Nationals short program.
She's missed a year. Here's the double axel where she opened the program with.
Now, what I liked about was her aerial position. I would have liked maybe a bit more speed or a bit more attack going into that jump.
Here's a layback.
Nice arch in the back.
Double flip into the double toe. Now, this will not be awarded a plus on the combination jump, but there was no definite deduction.
Now, what would have been the reasons for a skater to deviate from her planned content? If you could imagine, we don't know, but what would you imagine?
There's many reasons. First of all, there could have been like an injury that she has to deal with but decided to compete anyway. There could have been just sickness, not being able to physically achieve the triple jumps.
So her short program score, 33.97. Daniela Bella-Favot from Western Ontario makes her home in Windsor.
La prochaine concurrente, représentant le club de patinage artistique de Vaudreuil, du Québec, Karine Chevrier.
Karine, she's at her third time at Nationals, first time in the senior event. She's missed a year and a half with an ankle injury.
Coached by Natalie Martin, her choreographers are Sébastien Britton and Jeffrey Buttle. Music is from the summer of 42.
One of my favorite music.
20 years old.
Double toe. Now the level of difficulty is more difficult. Connecting step into her triple saca.
Now what went wrong in that jump?
She dropped her right side on that back inside entrance, which is the setup for the jump, and she dropped that right side. Unfortunately, that she has to utilize the upper body a little bit more than she would usually, and that caused the over-rotation from the upper body on the landing. Jump, double axel. Unfortunately, she was very hesitant on that takeoff.
It's all in the timing in terms of jumps, isn't it? Big, bold curves in this step sequence.
Started off quite strong with the triple flip, the most difficult element of her program, but couldn't keep the momentum. Her flying spin, dead drop into a cannon position.
Karine Chevrier, I maybe would have liked to have seen a bit more energy. Perhaps the music would have carried her a bit more.
Seems like she's
so we'll be back with Karine Chevrier's marks after this short break. Please stay tuned, everybody. We're back. Karine Chevrier from Quebec just skated. Now, I have to say that the music has the potential to really draw you in, and yet she seemed to be skating on top of the music and not ever really getting into her program.
You're right, PJ. I just didn't feel that she was skating with the music, that they were in unison. This was the first jump, well executed, triple flip, double toe. And
problems.
Triple sow, and we saw the right side dropping on her takeoff. It's a dead drop.
The thing with the death drop is you have to really get into that position quite quickly and be able to sustain it.
She did attend her 8th revolution.
Flanked by coaches Nathalie Martin,
Julie
and
Marcotte.
Julie Marcotte.
Score,
36.57. Sometimes at these championships, it's about your own personal best and achieving your own goals.
That's right.
Jessica Amy Sargent from Red Deer, Alberta, 20 years old.
Her short program music, Tears in Heaven, composer Eric Clapton.
Can't ever go wrong with Eric Clapton, that's for sure. Coached by Jan Omark and Deborah Allen. Choreographer is Jadine Ferreira. Remember the name Ben Ferreira, it's his wife.
First element, triple toe.
Jessica Amy placed 13th at the challenge. For the double toe for the combination. So how is that kind of combination evaluated when there's an error between the two jumps?
Well, there's a minus two deduction on, especially when you add any turn in between or a step. It's not as costly as a fall, where you're leaving points behind. To do it on a straight line. We have choice of doing circular or serpentine.
Now, it looks to me as I'm watching Jessica Amy skate that she's got great power, great speed, and I think the slight loss of balance is as a result of adrenaline maybe, and just not feeling completely in control.
Her head is probably moving a little faster than
the feet.
In the feet. Beautiful double axel.
Terrific height.
Recover on the landing. I think there was so much power going into that jump that she was having a little bit of trouble controlling it. That drop. Is that her flying spin? With eight revolution. Playback. What a variation.
Jessica Amy Sargent.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Red Deer Figure Skating Club in Alberta,
trains in
Northwest
Edmonton,
Territories, Nunavut,
from Red Deer,
Jessica
Alberta.
Amy Sargent.
What I wanted to see was maybe a bit more strength when it came to sort of the upper body positions. I found that maybe she was a little bit cautious, exactly, tentative. Jan Omark. He said basically the same thing we did, that there wasn't the reach, that she seemed a little bit heavy. Look at the power she has going into this triple toe.
You know, you have to expect a landing. And to me, she went and kind of just knew there was a bit of a trouble, like, on the takeoff, and didn't really fight for it.
She did there, though. Triple south
double
toe.
She knew she couldn't afford another fall.
Fall carries with it a one-point deduction.
With a variation.
Mm-hmm. She's so cute. She is adorable. But really, what 20-year-old isn't?
It's true.
I mean, now an interesting question came in. While we're waiting for marks, in the screen we can see Kelsey McNeil, who will be our next skater. So a margin of 0.52 separates Jessica Amy Sargent from the leader, Karine Chevrier.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next
and we're halfway through our first group of women's competitors. An up close and personal view of what we were talking about, that last moment with a coach. This is Kelsey McNeil.
She was the junior champion in 2008, but a combination of body changes and injuries has kept her away from qualifying at the nationals. Her goals here is to skate the best she can and to learn from it.
She's skating to feeling good. Coaches are Kathy Grenier and Robert Luger, who is also her choreographer.
Double axel, gonna step out, minus two. Triple toe and double toe combination. Again, a little deduction
for the turns in between.
But she seems to go for it though. She seems to be determined to. And
ooh, that's a hard fall.
Triple sound, missing some rotations there. I believe this was under-rotated, but now you always have to see on the video to make sure when you do the call. Five, six, seven, eight. She's got her level four combination spin. See that she has kept a spiral sequence, since we don't really have that, all that length of the spiral sequence that you used to have in the music. Oh no,
slight loss of focus there. That fall will cost is a 1 point deduction in that step sequence.
And a point on the total score. Flanks it with a broken leg.
You know, Kelsey McNeil, what I like about her is her natural grace. I think we'll be seeing a little bit more of her.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Petit-Kodiak District Figure Skating Club in New Brunswick, Kelsey McNeil.
And we'll be back with Kelsey McNeil's marks right after this short break. Please stay tuned. Bye. We're back, getting ready for the marks from Kelsey McNeil. She really struggled a little bit in this performance, I thought, although I liked her innate grace. When she sort of under-rotated a jump, the good news is that you can still earn 70% of the jump as long as you rotate it almost fully. Wow, look who's just arriving on deck. Cynthia Phaneuf.
You remember when we were talking about when the skaters are arriving? So the first group is already on the ice, and then the last group of skaters are just making their way in into the arena.
I wonder what people did before iPods.
There was Discman, BJ. I remember that.
Well, that triple-toe, double-toe combination was probably one of the highlights. She has very tidy feet in the air.
But she went for it. That's, you know, there was gutsy. There's days that it's going to work, and there's days that it's going to be a little more challenging and a bit more difficult. The fact that she was aggressive and going for it, she's going to have to learn to control that, you know, that power. But on the other hand, I kind of liked her skating too. Just like you, I'm sure we're going to see her more.
This is Sarah Jourdain.
Alongside with Yvonne Desjardins.
Now, Sarah is skating to Tango Mango. It's a cute piece. Sebastian Britton was the choreographer. She's 20 years old and from Laval. Placed at 11th at the challenge event. First time qualifying for senior nationals.
Great height, great distance in the jump. And the flow on the landing. Very well done. Great speed going into triple flip combination. Single toe. That's unfortunate. Just got a little anxious for the second jump there.
Anticipated the takeoff, just didn't give herself enough time. So in the case of a combination that should either be triple-triple, triple-double, or double-double.
A lot of skaters, PJ, in the field of the ladies, choose to do their technical, like their hardest technical elements at first. Trying to get them away and then concentrate more on the performance level. It's not always good when you're missing the first couple jumps. But for Sarah here, this seems to be the way to go. Five, six, seven, eight rotation in the cannon and more. Like the speed and the combination spin. Well centered. She's starting her step sequence on one foot for half of the length of the pattern. It's hard to see in studio, but it seems like she has reached the half mark.
Talking about assessing things like the step sequence, we're talking about achieving what we call bullets. or features. Same with the spins.
So she's got a level four and a layback, I believe, if I counted right. She had a variation, the side layback to the back layback, a grab. We call it the hair cutter, and then the Bellman position.
Le CPA, les Lames d'argent du Québec, Sarah Jourdain.
A terrific introduction to senior national competition from Sarah Jourdain. Very unfortunate combination. So by doing the single jump, does she get a penalty or does she just get the value of that single jump?
She just gets the value of the single jump. It has to be.
The rules say.
Yeah, it has to be a double combo with a triple or a triple-triple.
Now backstage, Cynthia Phaneuf is sizing up the competition, watching what's going on the monitor. Is that really what's happening, or is it just a bit of a distraction, perhaps?
Well, she's training with Cynthia, right? So Sarah, she's probably interested in knowing how she's done.
Sarah Jourdain takes over a decisive lead by just about 9 points. The score 45.69.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next competitor from the Houston Figure Skating Club in the British Columbia Yukon, please welcome Jacqueline Liniac.
Jacqueline Liniac. From Terrace, British Columbia, coach and choreographer Jill Marie Harvey. She's 18 years old. And this is her first trip to senior nationals. She was 10th at the challenge. First element, triple flip.
She hang on for 2 seconds on that one.
She lost the second jump, the double toe of her planned combination.
Triple loop, a little bit outside of the circle on this one. Great fight on the landing.
And it appeared to be fully rotated.
Level four, they're giving her the flexibility on the torso. Axle, singled.
Again, the required element is a double or a triple axle, so this will weigh heavily in the technical component scores. Technical element score. Lovely arch in that layback position. I think that what Jacqueline is going to go back and work on is polishing the elements, trying to develop perhaps a bit more finesse. To me, she carries herself very high in the knees, do you know what I mean? Has a nice takeoff from the jump.
Yeah, I find that she's got the energy, but not the finesse and not the polishing. Yes.
Jacqueline Leniuk, representing the BC
and Yukon section. Figure Skating Club in British Columbia, Yukon, Jacqueline Leniuk.
Set up for this triple flip. It just seemed like she just popped off that landing edge. So wasn't able to execute the jump for that combination.
Triple loop, you saw how she went a big detour on the outside of the circle. And she had to really utilize her muscle to finally
facilitate that triple loop. Now I do like the change in positions and a beautiful arch in the back.
It's very hard in the layback to get the attitude. What I mean by that is get the free knee of the free leg off, like far from the skating leg.
To make that beautiful silhouette.
And the arch that you're talking about.
You know, in some ways, getting to the national championships is certainly a mountain to climb. And then to really go out and fight through that performance again.
Well, these are the best 18 skaters of the country.
Quite an accomplishment. Now, in these moments, as the skater is waiting for their marks, it's interesting always to sort of see the coaches as they're relating to the skater. I mean, it's a very fine line you walk between trying to critique their performance and also support what they've done. Current score to beat 45.69, achieved by Sarah Jourdain, the skater just before Jacqueline Leniuk, and her marks 33.36. So this current standing, Sarah Jourdain first, Karine Chevrier in second, Jessica Amy Sargent in third, then Kelsey McNeil, Daniela Bellafavo, and Jacqueline Leniuk. Here's the order of skate for group two, Isabelle Valiquette, Riley McCullough-Casarsa, Jessica Dubé, Devin Newells, Kate Charbonneau and Dallas Daniel. Jessica Dubé in white. We haven't seen her without partner Bryce Davis in quite some time, but as you said before, a very experienced singles competitor. This is Isabelle Valiquette, ninth at the challenge event. Last year at National, she was 12th, coached by Stephanie Gard. Raleigh McCullough-Casarsa represents Western Ontario, coached by Shelley Barnett and Joanne McLeod. Shelley Barnett, coach of World Champions Nexus from a couple of years ago, synchronized skating team. She was 8th in the challenge event, 9th at last year's Nationals, only 16 years old. Jessica Dubé qualified for these national championships in 7th place from the challenge event. Now, in 07 and 08, she did qualify to skate at Canadians, although withdrew before skating the free. Did not skate singles the last 2 years competitively, but in the absence of partner Bryce Davison, is back to compete. Devin Newells from the BC Yukon Territory section. She placed first at her sectionals, 6th at the challenge event, and is coached by Keegan Murphy. Keegan, a former senior men's competitor. Kate Charbonneau, coached by Robert Tebbe and her mother Lori Wallace, placed 5th at the challenge event. She was the 2009 junior Canadian champion. She was 6th at Junior Worlds in 2010.
She just added the Triple S in 2010 to her repertoire.
And Dallas Daniel, who was just getting some last-minute instructions from coach Scott Davis. She was 10th at last year's Nationals and placed 4th at the challenge event. Lots going on in this warm-up group, second of three warm-up groups, and we'll be back right after this short break with lots more great skating from Victoria. Please stay tuned. Hi, everybody. We're back with our second group of women's competitors on the ice here at the 2011 BMO Canadian Figure Skating Championships from Victoria, British Columbia. So, José, I've been getting emails at pjkwong@pjkwong.com with questions for you. This one is from Kathy McIntosh. How do you think our ladies stack up on the world stage?
Well, like I said, the technical side of our ladies is quite strong. We don't see any triple axel at this point as our Canadian champ, like Canadian skaters, but as far as the quality in the technical side is all there. I think that shows the strength of the coaches in Canada. The ladies could do really well. I think it takes one, and Joanie has opened the door to believe that it could be there, that it could be there for them.
Another interesting question from Rebecca Bays. You have twins. She wants to know if your kids skate.
They're Canadians. They're going to skate for sure. So they are both into figure skating, and my son is also into hockey, and my daughter is skating 3 times a week right now. Yes.
Are they going to skate dance?
Well, if they're going to skate, they'll choose the discipline that they are, you know, going to be the best at, probably. Right now my struggle is she wants to jump to the non-common way, to the right, and I'm trying to get her to jump to the common
way. But now, this is, I got to tell you, I'm going to interrupt you here for a second. This is a great question from Alan Glasgow. Since you were a world competitor, what are the positive changes and negative changes of the new system?
The positive changes is you're focusing on your personal best. I think for the skater is the best way to know that they are improving and the most motivating way, because you can see from competition to competition. You don't have to wait for 1 year after the other at national. I think this is the best for developing the skaters. The downside of it is it's becoming very, very mathematic, and you don't see maybe the Casablanca of Kurt Browning as much, because every spin has to have, or you want to achieve like a level 4. It's not like necessarily just based on the choreography, although you have genius choreographer like David Wilson, Laurie Nicole, like Shailen Bourne, and you know, theirs were so rich as choreographer that they managed to do like some very creative program that brings you into a different era here and there. But yeah, it's challenging to be as creative so with the new system.
Pluses and minuses. Now, one more quick tweet from ThomasFan2010 here at Skating PJ. He wanted to know, what's the challenge event? We've been speaking in skating vernacular. The challenge event is the qualifying event to get to these national championships. It's where the best of the East and the best of the West come together and compete early in December. And they're competing for the spots available that are not taken up by skaters who've already qualified with BIDE events. So that's the challenge. And thank you for all your great questions and comments. At Skating PJ is where I am on Twitter. PJ Kwong at PJKwong.com on email. Very familiar face of that coach.
Stefan Ivars, coaching in Boucherville.
Isabelle Valiquette, ninth at the challenge, 12th last year at the Nationals. Skating to paint it black. Circular step sequence.
On one foot. Now the shape of the circle seems to be a little affected there. You're allowed to go in and out, but as long as the overall shape keeps a circular
formation.
I thought she was a little short on that one foot. Flexibility.
Losing a little bit of speed there with the transition into that final broken leg position. Good speed, nice height.
It's rare in the ladies' event that we see an Arabian. We'll see the death drop and we'll see the flying camel and the flying sit. But the Arabian and the way she executed it was quite big and high.
We'll be back with marks for Isabelle Valiquette right after this short break. Please stay tuned. We're back This is Isabelle Veliquette being greeted at the door by coach
Stéphanie Vars.
Set up for that triple. There was almost a delay going into that rotation. That can't help.
Because she did have the air time to accomplish three rotation, but you're right, she was a little slow to snap into her backspin rotation position.
Losing the second jump from that triple salut for the combination. Now this is the circular step sequence
that we were talking. See, to me, like, she's not, she didn't seem like, when I look at a circle, I see 4 points. It's like you're cutting a piece of pie, and you have to reach the end of that piece of pie. Even though you're going in and out of that straight line, like if you draw a circle, but you still need to achieve the 4 points.
To hit all the marks on the circle, right. Or else it's not really a circle. On the ice, getting her feet under her. You can see in the monitor, Riley McCullough Casarsa.
This lady will turn 17 this weekend.
She's looking for an early birthday present with a good short program, I bet. So Isabelle Veliquette, I like the speed that she clearly has. She just didn't seem to have the control that we would like to probably have at the senior ladies level. Score of 39.62 moves Isabelle Veliquette into second place, just behind Sarah Jourdain, who still has a score of 45.69 and the lead. Translated, that means, oops, I better get it together for the free. Correction, that mark is 35.62. Still with the lead, Sarah Jourdain in first. And this is Riley McCullough Casarsa. Good speed going into and out of that jump. Coached by Shelley Barnett and Joanne McLeod, she was eighth in the challenge event.
Good for her. We had a small deduction, landed on 2 feet. Last year, some nerves got to her during her short program. And her coaches have been working strongly on getting her, like, the toughness of the mental side of competing.
choreographers are Mary Angela Larmer and Julie Gros.
Sparrow into the double action.
Great speed in the flying camel. Variation. Variation. Level 4, flying spin. Now the thing is, when we're talking about levels 3, 4, we're just doing what we think and how we're evaluating it as coaches. The levels are not confirmed, of course, until the judging panel decides. Formation spin with a back entrance entry. She looks quite pleased with her performance.
Ladies and gentlemen, Madame and Monsieur from the Burlington.
And we'll be back with marks for Riley McCullough-Casarsa right after this short break. So a very strong skate from Riley McCullough-Casarsa. What are your thoughts, Jose?
Well, I liked her skating and I like her determination. She went out there, she wanted to accomplish the jump. She had to work a little bit on certain landings, but she managed to execute every element.
And some lovely technical prowess. Now, I think she might have touched down with the free foot on the landing of that triple loop.
She did.
So I didn't just see that, you did too.
Makes the two of us.
Now the penalty for a little touchdown on the free foot. Are we looking at a minus one? If it's fully rotated?
It depends if there was some weight. I believe there was a little bit of weight on it, and that could be up to a minus two. And that's basically the judges, because they judge how well the jump was executed, so that's up to the judges, and they take the average of it. They eliminate the highest and the lowest mark, and then...
Coach Shelley Simonton Barnett on the right.
Oh, hi everyone, I'm GSS.
On the ice, getting her feet under her, Jessica Jubé, who will be our next competitor.
Now Jessica Dubé.
Now Jessica has been talking both to Bryce and to other people in Victoria about the fact that it's a very different dynamic skating by yourself when you're used to having that pair skater with you, that pair, you know, that pair to focus on. So music is from the Amelie soundtrack. Short program was choreographed by Scott Moyer.
You know, it may be a little bit more difficult, but it's every year is a challenge. And like she said, if it was meant to happen, it's better this year than next year. And she is going to learn from this and bring it into the pairs after. Who knows? Maybe she'll continue to do singles too.
That makes for a busy schedule. Now, Jose qualified to come to the Canadian Championships by finishing in seventh place at the challenge. At the challenge, she had only really been skating singles for about 4 weeks.
Thank you.
Axel. Triplets, double toe, good for her. Now, slight drop to the outside of the circle on the landing edge of that double toe, compromising the flow. As Bryce was telling you, they were working on their singles once they, very nice position there. I like the program. I do too. I think it suits her. What I meant is to come with even such a short time with a program well prepared to nationals and being to put on that kind of choreography. It's impressive. It makes me wonder what she would be like if she had a full season to train. Sadly, she doesn't want the full season to train this way, that's for sure. But to see her have goals for herself, I think is very important and one of the ways that she can continue.
And you know, one thing that is going for her is she adapts. This is what it's going to be this year, then okay, what am I going to do?
I think it's just a lack of confidence a little bit, but very well done, up in the air, just a little bit of hesitation on the landing. Now this
is the jump that often even in pair skating she has some difficulty with.
It's an edge jump, and if you're not over the circle with the upper body on the takeoff, then you have to work really hard to get through the jump.
Now, the edge quality and the very long way that she's going on one foot in the straight line step sequence speaks to her ability as a skater, I think. Score to beat is 45.69 points. Lead is held currently by Sarah Jourdain.
Jessica's coach was just thanking the lady that did the dress. I'm assuming like a few it took a few people's effort, like as a team, like to pull the program, the choreography, the costumes all together.
Devin Newells, I didn't mean to drop, but Devin Newells on the ice. She's going to be our next skater. Now,
they say it takes a village to raise a child. I think it takes a village to get a skating dress on the ice some days. It's a very pretty dress, though, so congratulations to the villagers. Jessica Dubé takes over the lead with a score of 48.81. Devin Newells, coached by Keegan Murphy and his mother Eileen Murphy. Keegan, a former senior men's competitor. Devin placed first in sectionals in the BC Yukon Territory section. At the challenge, she placed sixth. Choreographers are Mark Pillay and Joanne McLeod. Double axel. The angle on that takeoff edge was completely off.
A very flat landing.
Didn't look to me like she had to reach behind with a free foot to plant the pick in order to get up into the air.
She's a beautiful skater and she's got great, great flexibility. Chukasau struggling with the technical side.
Maybe a slight hesitation getting into the air for that triple salve, impeding her ability to complete the three revolutions.
Increase the speed.
I like her use of the music. And attention to detail in the upper body movements.
Great speed in the combination spin.
And a nice tight center. Good edge work in that straight line step sequence.
Executed from her part, but today the technical jumps were not there. Bullets leaning to the right.
Tell me about the preparation for that jump. Did you feel that perhaps it was a little early?
Yeah, she kind of like felt the rush, I think, going into it. It was a little bit anxious and didn't really take the time for the reach back.
You know, it's an interesting thing. There's absolutely no way to anticipate how your body is going to react to adrenaline. So the only way to really be able to learn about nerves is to get nervous and then learn from it.
Doing simulation of competition and compete as often as possible. Learn about yourself, how you can control it, and what works for you.
Coach Eileen Murphy beside Devin Newells. I sometimes say that this is the most important few minutes that a coach can spend with a competitor, because I think that what the words that are said here are what helped us set the competitor up for future competitions and not just the free program.
Because the skater is actually performing, hard to think at the same time.
The short program score,
37.92.
Lead is still held by Jessica Dubé with a score of 48.81.
So sometimes when you come off the ice, you're not too sure what happened. You don't know exactly how you skated because you're focusing on the moment and where you are. So at the beginning of the program, sometimes could be a little bit of a blur, and then your coach can walk through it.
Now this is Kate Charbonneau, 17 years old, skating to Malagueña.
Kind of like the dress.
I do too. Coached by Laurie Charbonneau and Robert Tebbe. Choreographers Shailen Bourne and Sebastian Britton. Kate was the junior national champion in 2009. Placed seventh last year. Qualified to come to these events by placing fifth at the challenge.
Triple toe. Step out. Followed by a double toe. Second element, triple flip,
slight touchdown on the free foot on the landing, I would say,
and under rotated. Now, I would have to see it again on the slow motion to see if she is going to be awarded the full point, or if it's more than a quarter cheat, then it's going to be 70%.
Now, what that means is it's 5.3 points for a fully rotated triple flip versus 3.7 with a slight under rotation. Now what I like about Kate is she has great energy and speed, and I like the way that the programs are constructed. I would have liked to have seen more height on that double axel, so there was no reason to not be able to get the full landing.
Seems she didn't really use the push on that takeoff and just utilized the speed. She went across, but with no curve up in the jump. Nice spin. Great control on that position. Layback, sideways. Back layback. Hair cutter into the Billman.
Great arch in the back. What I also like about this program is that it moves from element to element. And even with the errors, it's still a very nice program to watch.
Yes.
Charbonneau, and we'll be back with her marks after this short break. Stay tuned to Victoria. Kate Charbonneau, taking a seat in the Kiss and Cry, being flanked by Robert Tebbe, and I think her coach, Mom Lori Wallace-Charbonneau. Shame about that combination, just a slight loss of focus. Hard to tell about that triple flip.
It is a shame about the jumps, because the choreography, her flexibility, her presentation, her program component scores, because she did have some transition and throughout the program, is at a level of the senior ladies, and it's unfortunate that the jumps weren't there today. We'll probably see it in the long program. I don't think she's going to get 2 days like this, so the ability, the strength, and the potential is there.
And she's still very young. 17 years old.
You're right.
Okay, so the current score to beat, 48.81. Lead is held by Jessica Dubé. And currently in fourth place. That will give her a bit of a mountain to climb in order to make the top five at nationals. Scott Davis looking on to giving some last minute instructions to skater Dallas Daniel.
I'm looking forward to see this young lady, because I saw her jumping in throughout the warm-up, and she looked quite solid. Her triple jumps were secure in the warm-up.
And she's skating to Jupiter from the planets. Choreographer for the short program and the free program, Cindy Stewart. I like her speed already.
Oh, single the legs.
And that was her intended combination.
But she could actually do the combination on the second triple and add a jump. Triple toe. She didn't. A little struggle on the landing.
It feels as if she's rushing. Particular performance that Dallas doesn't seem to be really connecting to the music.
Skating from one element to the other.
And this is a skater with lots of promise. 18 years old. So lots of time still to develop.
Layback spin.
The The judges are looking for what degree of arch in that back, in the layback.
Also the flexibility of that free leg too. The higher it is, the more flexibility it requires.
Ladies and gentlemen, representing the Kalalta Community Figure Skating Club from Alberta Northwest Territories, Nunavut, Dallas Daniel.
I do like her technique. I think Scott has done a good job at getting her Cindy Stewart as a choreographer. She's an amazing choreographer, and she's got such a wide repertoire of style, Cindy Stewart. Just the way she carries herself, I think it will benefit Danielle. Now we saw the singlets, you know, and her upper body was already gone before she actually went into the jump.
But I do like the tidiness of, you're right, the technique is very good, that triple toe. Too bad she couldn't really secure the landing to do a second jump.
And we didn't see it to its full justice in the program, but what I saw in the practice, in the 6-minute warm-up, I can tell you, yes, the technique is there.
Maybe with a little bit more experience competing, she'll be able to sort of, you know, harness that energy and not let the energy overtake her.
This is something that you learn through experience, right? So the more you compete, the better you get and the more comfortable you are. But also you take tricks, because you know what? Nationals, Olympics, Worlds, how many Olympics there is? One Olympic every 4 years. How can you get used to that kind of pressure, right? So you're going to have to deal with that pressure once in a lifetime at some point or another. So, but the thing is, you grow and you learn to deal with that adrenaline. If it takes over, how can I come down? How can I control it?
Well, and that's the thing, you know, that we have to really think about is how skaters can be best prepared for that once-in-a-lifetime moment. And for some of them, once-in-a-lifetime is also Canadians. So how you can help as a coach to...
Right. And you have to work with your coach, because your coach kind of knows you, absorbs you on a daily basis. So between the coach and you, you can find some ways. Like sometimes it's just to, you know, let it all out, scream if you need to, but or other times it's just learning how to breathe, do some yoga.
But not during the program.
No.
Because that would be very difficult. But breathing is one of the things that people have to learn how to do, truly, during the program.
What do I say to my skater when they start their program? Say, you're skating on frozen water, not underwater. You can breathe.
38.99 is the score for Dallas Daniel. And that may be what I was responding to. It looked like she was holding her breath during that program. But it comes with experience. So two-thirds of the way through the competition. Some great skating so far. In the lead, Jessica Dubé with a score of 48.81, followed by Sarah Jourdain. Then Dallas Daniel is in third, narrowly ahead of Kylie McCullough-Kasarsa. Then Kate Charbonneau in fifth place, Devin Newells in sixth place, and the rest of the field follows. We'll be back with lots more action from Victoria after this short break.